Fungi. I bet you never realize how fun of a guy he actually is, right? Just want to say thank you so much to Flip for suggesting sugar, water, yeast around the CO2 video. I always love getting into the science of things, and after I started to dive into this topic, it led into one video, into another video, into a documentary, into a Netflix series, thinking about it all night, and you're here with Mark Balwa at Perfect Gardens. We're going to get into it. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. If you haven't checked out our YouTube membership site, please go ahead and do so. I've set up an inexpensive way for creating a little bit better communication for people that need their questions answered a little quicker. Just like how Flip was suggesting, sugar, water, and yeast creates ethanol and discharges CO2. There are a number of different experiments that show you on the internet how to mix sugar, yeast, and water to create your own CO2 in your growing environment. Although, to get into the science a little bit about what's happening during the fermentation process is yeast is fungi, and the fungi are eating the sugar that is glucose, which is produced through photosynthesis normally, and ends up creating ethanol and CO2. And another gentleman ended up suggesting growing your own oyster mushrooms because they give off quite a bit of CO2 as well. I think both of these suggestions would actually be absolutely phenomenal to implement in your grow room. As I was watching the different documentaries, I actually ended up having to go back and pulling out a couple lines through each of these documentaries, and I wanted to share them with you guys kind of as I wrote them out and see where this video goes. It's not going to have a lot of specific how-tos, but I thought these little details when I watched these videos kind of created a much more deeper appreciation for fungi and what they do. So, fungi eat dead things. Fungi are a kingdom in their own right. Fungi are more related to animals than to plants because they have to eat other organisms. Fungi produce enzymes, amino acids, to break down rocks into soil. Scientists look for different fungi because of the compounds, amino acids, and we talked about what amino acids. Amino acids are nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, and sulfur. So scientists look for different fungi because of the compounds, amino acids, they create. Some cure cancer, others break down human waste, and others create beer for us. Fungi release hyphae, kind of like the roots for fungi, drill into rocks and extract minerals. Hyphae's pressure when pushing through the rocks are 100 times greater than the pressure in your tires. I mean, that's enormous. You really think about it, right? You ever think about how rock becomes into soil, right? And it's because of these root systems are capable of literally, just the fungi are capable of penetrating through rocks. I mean, just imagine the rocks if you're hiking and you pick up a little rock and it's so just tough. Roots have no issues penetrating through that and accessing the minerals within them. Fungi exploit sugars out of plants in the form of exudates, and in exchange, fungi give plant minerals for rocks. Fungi will even penetrate cell walls, so the cells will take phosphates when creating ATP, which is the energy unit of the plant. Because when the plant creates a sugar, it still has to combine itself to 3-phosphates before it becomes ATP, which stands for adenosine triphosphate. There are 2 types of fungi in the wood wide web. They are decomposers. Those fungi break down dead stuff, and if those fungi didn't exist, all minerals would be locked up in dead things. The second type of fungi is mycorrhizae, the ones that produce hyphae and search for roots and find ways inside and will provide water and minerals in exchange for sugars. They are endo and exto. They are the mycorrhizae that create a relationship around the roots, and then they're the mycorrhizae that create the relationship within the roots. When this connection happens, the root systems become plants and are now connected and can exchange nutrients between each other. That's absolutely amazing. Just think about that for a second, guys. When you're growing in a grow bed versus in pots, that one plant that is in that pot is 100% reliant on itself to figure out all of its own problems. But when you grow in a grow bed and when you're growing with diversity, plants rely on each other to solve their own problems. Realizing these things made me want to introduce other plants that have symbiotic relationships. Obviously, right now I'm talking to the smaller growers, the ones that have the ability to grow some food right along with all the other plants that they're growing in the garden. And when you grow a full diversity of plants, because of all the different types of amino acid chains that the fungi and bacteria are capable of creating, you're going to have a much higher quality at the end of your harvest. Fungi are master chemists that make molecules that are still impossible for human beings to replicate. Why is ant poop and insect flasks so important? It's because of the fungi that live on it. That includes the bat guanos and the worm castings and all those things. things. Remember, fungi are decomposers. Mycorrhizae absorbs nutrients such as phosphorus, magnesium, nitrogen. When you get really into it, it's the reason why fungi hold on to sulfur. Fungi are capable of creating any amino acid needed and that has ever been created on this planet. Fungi were here before us, and fungi will be here long after us. I love having new awarenesses to different things because with these new awarenesses, I'm able to take something that I use all the time and implement it in a new way in my garden, which will overall reduce the confusion because I don't need new products or more products. I just am becoming more familiar with the things I'm already using. Anyways, I just want to say thank you so much. I know this video was kind of more of a ramble than anything else. Like I said, there was a whole bunch of little things that popped out at me at these last 12 hours of getting into fungi that I just wanted to share with you guys that I thought were impactful to myself and I thought might be also impactful to you guys. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Have a great grow, everyone. So initially, when you just have like, let's say a hydrogen and an oxygen, for example, together, that's an amino acid. Well, let's say you have three or four of those combinations put together, that becomes a peptide.